Šodien mums ir tēvu diena. Tēvu dienai veltīts Dievam.
Today there is a Father's Day and our church service is dedicated to Father's Day and I have a feeling that Father's Day, what kind of celebration is that? How important is that? But then I have the other argument. God has revealed himself as a father, as a heavenly father. And it would mean to mean, it would mean
Katrs varbūt mēs esam redzējuši to.
Every one of us has seen the picture that illustrates if man and woman would be electrical device, then men are like that they have one button to turn on and turn off. And for ladies, they have so many different buttons, different regulators, sensitivity regulators, and there are no instructions how it works. In every individual case, it works differently. And as a TBN president said, tell your jokes, but say that it's a parable. There is an old parable that God spoke to a man that he prayed. That it's not so easy. The ones that are married, anyone is married here, wouldn't you agree that it's not easy? When this electronical system has those indicators, then it's not easy for neither one of them. I'd like to say that as role of God, people say, why would you need God? Is it difficult to live on your own? Do you need God? The role of God in society is reduced to some afterlife living. And in life they don't need God, but how it is with a father. And today I want to make this thing bigger. That role of father is just one of the missions that man has this great mandate in this world. And that role of man is a little bit decreased. So without a man, children cannot be coming to the world, but then after the children are born, then the role of the father has been decreased in society. And there was a teacher who asked his children to his students to raise hands if their father is not living in their life in their families anymore. And there was half of the students had their father had left them. And the problem was very common. And then I thought, imagine half of the children do not know father's figure. Maybe on some celebrations he gives them some gifts and then gives back to their mother who needs to discipline, who needs to raise. I imagine how it is for worldly people that they stay like that children who don't have God, they grow up with that and maybe lose overall this role of father. How important that is. It's not a role that you need to submit your whole life to, yet it's still so important. The Heavenly Father. And how privileged are believers that you have someone that comes in this hall and says, yes, I am your Heavenly Father. And I like how he in the book of Isaiah says, even though mountains would step away, my grace will not step away from you. My dear brother and sister, perhaps you have grown up in a family where father went away from difficulties because saw somewhere some snack that he could eat, and you have stayed. Dear friend, I encourage you to come to your Heavenly Father and let him compensate for your soul, for your life vision. How is a real Heavenly Father that he is faithful even if the whole world is against you? He is still with you always. Our Heavenly Father. And I tried to remember in Bible when there was the first time when something was said about the role of the father and what God wanted to do through him. And in the Genesis chapter 2:15, God made a man, Adam, and put him into the Garden of Eden. Then the Lord God took the man and put him in the Garden of Eden to tend it and keep it. Verse 15. To tend it and keep it. It's not written that he put man in the Garden of Eden. He didn't put it in the Garden of Eden so that he would eat and enjoy, just simply wander around the garden. It's written that God gave him assignment, a mission for every man, whether he is 5 or 55 years old or 105 years old. He has this assignment in this world to give something, not to take from this world. Not that I'm the one who needs to receive, but the one who tends and keeps it. Man has been put in this world so that he would create a feeling of safety. And I listened to a journalist a time ago, and he said interesting fact that I remember well. He said, the sense of safety is more important than love. That for a child growing up, love is important. We all know that people search for love. Everyone searches for love. But he said that this sense of safety, stability, that you have a back, there is someone that you can come no matter what, that for a child, for his personality, for development, this sense of safety, it's very important and more important than love. And I remember my father, who had 4 classes, he only had four years of school. And someone might think that he didn't even have high school. And he said, mother had 9 years of schooling, I only have 4. But there's one thing that he had learned. He had seen a bad example of the father. My grandfather was a chronic alcoholic all his life. He was an adulterer. He was a terrorist in his own home. He terrorized the people that were the closest one. On the outside, he was nice and entertainer, friendly, but when he came home, when his family was alone with him, then everyone didn't feel safe. He said, my father said, I don't want to be like that. And he said, what his father didn't do, he tried to do. My father was not ideal. Yes, he had experienced Jesus. Jesus has brought something in his life, and he tried to give as a real father was. And sometimes it happened loudly, sometimes there were some conflicts, but never I heard a thought, even at the level of thoughts that he was tired, nothing like that. Father was like a God, he was faithful. And in my opinion, it was something that gave such a feeling that you can stand on your feet and you know the foundation that you stand upon is always there. And he gave for a man this assignment. And that was very, very much. And I want to say that slowly, since the falling into the sin, from a holy one, God, from a holy falling into the sin, man lost the revelation of God, and people have made all sorts of gods that he liked, and it surpasses the greatest sinners. Just read about religions of India. There are so many gods that it's just unimaginable. This revelation of God has been lost, and also this revelation about the role of Father. And I'd like to say that from a father that had to give sense of stability and protection and safety, caring, an average stereotypic man is associated as a danger. Try not to agree to me, but for example, in the evening, you go on the old Riga's streets, there's no people on the street, and a lady comes in front of you, and you see that she comes to you. What would you think? Why is she coming close to you? Probably she is lost. She will come and ask, where is that street, where is that object, or where is McDonald's? Forgive me, please, women never ask like that. You would not be afraid. She doesn't ask where is McDonald's, didn't you see a small cat? This my cat. Did you see him? You will not be afraid, but if you go on the same street and you see that a man comes and he comes to you, wouldn't you be afraid? If you are a lady, you would hold onto your bag tighter. You have some worry. And let's try to and the man that God has created so he would be a safety garment. You are in this, on these streets, all the windows are closed, and suddenly three men come in front of you, everyone is in masks. Just like you are sitting here in masks and they come to you, what would you think? They would say, someone would say they are searching for a dog. Most probably you wouldn't think like that. You would think, they are coming, they are approaching you, you would be already starting to run away, taking off your high heels and getting ready for the cross. But if a three ladies come, six ladies, all of them are in masks, what would you think? You would think that nurses are coming after the work. You would start to sing the song, "May Lord bless you." How did it happen that the ones that God created so they would create stability have become a danger? How did it happen that my grandfather, from a man who loved a woman, married her and birthed children, that he became a terrorist? Why did it happen like that? Why? And how could that be that it has such a big meaning? And I would like for us to watch a video that illustrates that this revelation about losing the relation about man, it's such a great impact. In Bible there are two verses that every Christian man has to live by. Stand strong. Watch, stand fast in faith, be brave and be strong, let all that you be done with love. Let's think about events in Afghanistan. We have seen in airport how people want to get away from Afghanistan. What kind of people want to run away from Afghanistan? It's adult men. And this is people who have, these are people who have found a way to get into a plane that will depart now. You can see that there are some ladies and some children, but 70-80% are young men. It reminds of Syria refugees crisis when 10,000 of Syrian refugees stepped into Europe. Most of all those men who were the people that could protect themselves the best in the war zone, adult men, and who are the people who can run away from territory, men. So people who can protect themselves the most are the people who can run away the best and who can leave others. Think about Titanic. Let's have some statistics. There were 434 ladies on Titanic. And 324 ladies survived, so 75% survived. There were 112 children, 56 children survived, so 50% children survived. And there were 1,680 men, more employees than passengers, so 323 survived, only 90%. We could see why more ladies and children didn't survive, so the most children and ladies that didn't survive were at the bottom of the Titanic. And the first class children survived 100%. Most of the men died. Who were the people that could get into the boats the most? But the greatest amount of children died, and who were the people that were the hardest to get into the boats? So ladies and children, so greatest amount of people, greatest amount of men decided to die, not to leave women and children to save themselves, seeing the Syrian refugees who stepped into Europe. If Titanic would start a drone full of Syrians and Afghans, the statistics would show that men would survive the most. Why are these adult men leaving their sisters, their mothers, their wives, expecting that they can protect themselves against terrorists? Like this man, as when the fire comes.
Vai tiešām tu labāk izvēlētos
izdzīvot
un pamest sievietes
un bērnus? Kāpēc survive leaving women and children? Why these planes weren't full of women and children? There were some women and children. It means that some men fighted to get those in airplane. But these men were the smallest amount. Sometimes some people have some benefits, financial or status benefits, and sometimes to use those benefits is good, but sometimes the best thing to do is to use your benefits to people, to help people that don't have those benefits. When violence is happening, society becomes divided apart. Some ladies can defend themselves, but most of the time men have benefits. So if you are bigger, greater, richer, use your benefits. Let no others your place, then this is the result. In Ephesians 5:25, Paul said, husbands, love your wives just as Christ also loved the church and gave himself for her. Christ was at the cross because of church, and knowing Bible, we men, we have to be ready to die for our families, if that's needed. If your etalon of manhood is Christ, who didn't choose to use his benefits to gain for himself, but to save the ones who didn't have benefits, then following him, you will be a real man. And knowing the Bible verses in the beginning, watch, stand fast in the faith, be brave, be strong, let all that you do be done with love. Let's not use your benefits to raise above others, but use the benefits to help the ones that don't have those benefits. You know, I'm happy that I am not living in Afghanistan or Syria.
Kaut ko kristietība vēl ir saglabājusi mūsu zemē.
Something that Christianity has still maintained in our lands, if something similar happened, then the percentages would be different from what we saw right now. I want to return to 1 Corinthians 16:13. Watch, stand fast in faith, be brave and be strong. Let all that you do be done with love. This letter of Corinthians is not written to the man. Of course, it's written to man as well, but it's written to all the church. And it's important to know that and to realize that at the same time it's written to man, especially at this situation that we are at right now. All these things, all these orders, all these directions has been given to the ones who are in a fight. At the time of the war, we haven't been, maybe some have been, some in military mission, but in our childhood, boys were in some dangerous fights, and you know that you have to stand, watch and stand fast.
tu nevar mukt, tu nevar
you bēgt. Cannot escape.
Tas nebūs viegli, tev jāprāt,
it won't be easy. Jāprāt, you have to be as a man. You have to be strong.
Manuprāt, Pāvils arī domā,
and Paul
šo te, viņš runā par kauju,
talks zināt, about
mēs atrodamies
this,
tādā garīgā karā.
Knowing that we
tas,
are in a spiritual war, and if we are not informed
nedozīmē,
about that, or if we forget about that, it doesn't mean that we
tas,
are less danger.
Nezin, to nenozīmē, ka viņš ir drošāk nekā, drošākā vietā nekā tas, kurš uzmanīgi vēro zem. Drīzāk tā viņa vieglprātība, tā viņa bezbēdība un neinformētība nodrošinās viņam
the
saka.
The lack of information, the lack of fear will
manuprāt, miļa draug, ka notiek
put him in more danger. So there is a greater war than in Afghanistan when Taliban returns or in Syria, the civil war or Ukraine.
Notiek viens liels, plašs karš,
there is a
karš
great war, and there is a war
pret
against men, against
visi,
their role, against
apzi,
their mission, against their consciousness,
uzupurēt,
against their ability to sacrifice themselves, their strength and their privileges.
Un sākot jau pavisam, pavisam, pavisam pašā sākumā savas ģimenes dēļ.
And because of their families.
Uzupurēties savas spējas aiziet, aizmukt no grūtībām.
To run away from difficulties.
Tas norizītos to, lai to tavu spēku un to tavu vīrišķību un spēku
for your manhood to
tiktu galā
invest
grūtībām, lai
to handle difficulties and challenges.
And
Afghanistan is a bright example how men do what Western men do, just a little bit differently. In Afghanistan, they just leave their families at the hands of enemies. Being young, there was a friend of mine where we had our first young man things that you understand that you are not a small boy, but you are a young man that has to walk your own way. And my friend asked me, what would you do if you are walking with a girl and there are group of thieves coming? I wouldn't have a choice. What can you do? You have a girl next to you, you have to do everything that you can do to protect her. To what my friend said, what would they do with the girl? But you can run away. And I told him, you know what? With my sister, I would not let you be friends with. I wouldn't want my sister to have a boyfriend who would think, oh, what would they do for a lady? I would just run away.
Bet arī šodien mēs redzam ļoti
but today we can see often that people respected in society, they leave their children, their families, because it was difficult, because there weren't this excitement. It's important they just think about themselves. They took away the safety for the children, for their fiancés, for their wives, that they can be trustworthy. They run away to enjoy the life. And that is the thing that here in these verses, Paul said, don't do it like that, you are in a war where the status of man is one to be destroyed. So the figure of father. And I heard people who say that they cannot call God a father because father associates for them with everything bad, everything that has hurted. Paul says, don't do it like that. Endure, you are in a war. Devil wants to turn you into, how would I say, that you wouldn't be man anymore, that you would simply be just someone who's searching for a better life. Don't give up. Stand against that, and he talks about spiritual fight. Use faith, stand in faith. I dare to say that devil wants to destroy manhood in the world overall. As fighters, as patriots, as a man of faith.
Mans ticības tēvs Vilnis.
Mans
ticības tēvs. Kāds?
Father of faith, someone that has been a man that had one button on and off, but he was so simple that you couldn't misunderstand him. One type of values, any, no matter what the time is, good or bad times, he's God, no matter what, and the whole world could disappear, but he knew where to find his strength. My Heavenly Father, my dear friend, I want to say that as we accepted Jesus as our Lord, God has changed us. And even if you didn't have this positive example, someone that doesn't give up and doesn't create theology, if you didn't have this positive example, you can find this in your Heavenly Father, because he has put his nature in you, his strength. It's not something strange, it's something so harmonic in you that you can change the mistakes of your ancestors. You can become the pioneer in your ancestry, the one who shows what is a real man. And I want to end with two verses from Ephesians, and it's written, today we have, Edward, please come and play music in the background. I would like for us to really hear this, Ephesians 5:1. Therefore, be imitators of God as dear children. And I didn't say in the previous verse, but I believe that in our girls, there is this thing in this character to not give up, to not become bitter, even if you have experienced disappointment. God has given us that we can become strong in bringing testimony about him. Follow God as his dear children. Imitate him. The God who never, who is always faithful, who never betrays. Be imitators of him. And how we can imitate God? We were sinners before, and now we are. Who are we? We are God's children. You are from God. You have been born of God.
Alkoholiķi bērni fizioloģiski pārmanto kaut kādas noslēpumus un jūtības pret alkoholu. Tā mēs, kas esam dzimuši
no Dieva, who are born of God, we inherit his character. And I like how Apostle Paul says, why we can imitate God? It's not that we are afraid that something bad will happen, but he says, as dear children, not because of fear, but as the dear children, because you have experienced His love, unconditional love. We have experienced that we can experience that 24/7. You cannot lose that. You can do all the mistakes in your life, but you will not lose on His love. And He says, follow in His feet, footsteps, because you have been born of Him. Christian man, it's in you to give to this world His love. And it's our mission in this world. It's not that all your manhood finishes with that door of your apartment. No, you are generous and courageous. You know that God helps you. You know that He is in your side. You cannot fall. You know that if you will fall, He will not leave you. You know that God, Father, is with you and you are standing on a strong rock. Remember Psalm 27. He protects me in His tent on that malicious day.
And
then He says, at the shadow of His tent, He raises my legs on a mountain of rock, and then my head will be raised, even though my enemies see that. We all have an enemy in this world, very evil enemy, but God has raised your legs on a rock, and you stand in Jesus, and you have mission in this world. This previous illustration about Afghanistan, think two types of men. Man who leaves his family. He said, I love you all, but now I need to run away. And he ran away. And the man who came to airport carrying his children, and now he sees that he cannot get in the airplane. Everything is full. And now he says, praying, God, how can I save my child? And then he says to American warrior, and he says, I'm a Christian. I'm not afraid of myself, but please protect my child. And the American warrior says, and he has tears in his eyes, and says, I will do what I can. I will try to find a family who will take this child. And the father, leaving himself in the death, he said, thanks to God, that he can give his child a life. How God can change the heart of the man. I believe God did it with each one of us when we accepted Jesus as our Lord. Maybe we did not feel it. Maybe it doesn't always resonate with us. But I think that this is the time when God awakens us, because there are people around us who will perish. They will not lose their workplaces, they will lose everything. They will lose their awakeness. You and me, men and women born of God, and our destiny is safe. Our place in that airplane is already booked. When the time will come, we will be taken, and we will be there. We are already saved. But today here, we can give this message of God's love, that you have Heavenly Father, He loves you. And there is the second verse, and live in love as Christ has loved you and given yourself to God as a sacrifice. Real manhood is seen in Christ. He didn't fear about himself ever. He was not fighting for himself. He did it because of others. And we have this character in us.